We're super excited to introduce you to what we call our wholeness room or our wellness room at James Elementary. I tell them this is a place of peace and healing and restoration.
When I come here first, I feel sad and mad. But when I get relaxing and I just leave and I feel happy.
The goal of this program in this room is that it's a quick reset where you kind of come up into that best part of your brain so you're ready to learn again.
I leave happy and ready to get back to work.
We have a lot of sensory items and aromatherapy, so these are all things that they can do with their hands.
And then this is just to make you to calm down and you just gonna play with it.
They de-escalate, they talk it out and do a plan with me for some strategies, and then we talk about how can you have that successful re-entry back into the classroom.
It helped me focus on class because it's the type of stuff that she got to calm people down.
If I'm able to all of a sudden work out this interpersonal stuff, express what I need, reduce the number of incidences for things like that so that I have more time learning, that's going to start to have a really positive impact on my school grade.
The best room I ever saw.
This is our students' wellness room. We noticed that we have a lot of kids that are dealing with a lot of trauma, and sometimes they don't know how to de-escalate. So we set up this room to help them bring themselves back down to balance so that they're able to continue on with the rest of their day.
I was just like worried and stuff. Like my mom, she had something wrong with her heart, so I come in here sometimes to help get relief. And it helps.
They can come by teacher request. They can request to come, or we may see that something's happening in the hallway, and then we may say, let's go to the meditation room.
If I'm mad, I come in here. Or if I just need to calm down from people.
We have books for them to read. We also have a coloring book. We do have Mind Yeti that we use, which is an online program for mindfulness. Usually our students are coming in frustrated. They may not know how to communicate that. So it looks like anger. It may look like screaming. It may look like crying. And ultimately, once they go through the mindfulness program, they're able to walk out, and usually I say, how did that feel? And they're like, I needed that.